Hey guys, Ron Bond, Bondo Built Construction here. We gotta build a frame over this small garage that we're pouring today because of the rain. So I'll show you how we do it sometimes when we gotta get something done in the rain. So that's what we're at here. That's what we're trying to get done. So stay with us, guys. For this little garage here. So we're gonna build like an enclosure over this thing. So this is the garage. I got this garage in my other video. I was pouring this thing. It was a pain. Did it with a rear end truck. You should watch that video. But anyway, we got to build an enclosure over this thing so that we can pour this. It's not going to take much to pour it. But we just got to get it done. So that's what we're going to do today. Stay tuned. Hey guys, Bondo here. You're probably wondering what the heck I'm doing here. What we're doing, guys, is building a enclosure over this little tiny garage here. The reason we're doing this is I live in upstate New York, and it's been real hard to get concrete this year. I'm sure some of the other areas around the country are experiencing the same thing. But so we ordered this concrete. I think I ordered a couple weeks out in advance. So I had to get this job done, guys, because they're waiting. The builders were waiting to get this thing backfilled so they could finish this, you know, building the walls and stuff on this house. So the excavator wanted to get out of there, get his machines out of there and stuff. So they really wanted this done. So we decided to, let's just build a little tent over this thing and so we can pour it on this day. I mean, it was only, I think it was 2.5 yards or something. There was no concrete hardly at all. It's the smallest garage I've ever seen in my life, actually. Little Nudura garage here. We built this whole basement. I got some other videos on it, guys. I got a video on us pouring this little garage, and you know, actually it was a pain for being so small. But here we are, we're just putting up some, we just screwed some 2x4s and stuff up against the Nudura, and then we screwed them into the side of the deck on the house, and we put some 1x3 little rafters over it, and we just dragged a tarp over this thing. And, you know, it worked pretty good, actually. So we were able to get this job done, and everybody was happy. And it didn't ruin the concrete because, obviously, we couldn't pour it in this rain. It would ruin the finish. And we just hand-troweled this little garage, guys. If you stay with the video, you know, I'm going to pour it out and hand-trowel it. We're going to show you how we did it. It's a tiny little small garage, as you can see here, but maybe you can learn something from how we did it. I thought it was kind of cool how we built this little tent, because we really wouldn't have been able to get this job done for a couple weeks, which would have set the whole project back. So we're just screwing some 2x4s together here. We lacked a couple rafters from the little 1x3, so it took a couple. We used all their lumber that they had on site. We just borrowed it, let's say. I asked the homeowner if they minded us. We didn't cut nothing. We just screwed it together and used it, and we took it down the next day. I had this tarp, guys, and actually this tarp had a few holes in it, so we had to kind of be careful with it. But I've used this tarp a few times. We did some roofing with it and stuff, so it's got a couple holes in it. But for the most part, I kept most of the water off of it. We just dragged it over this thing, and here we are. That's what we're doing here. We're just pulling the tarp over it. I can't remember the exact size of that tarp, but it's just a cheap Harbor Freight tarp that you can get, or Lowe's or whatever sells them. The box stores sells these tarps. And I've used them before. We've done this before. This ain't the first time we've built little enclosures over stuff. We did one earlier this year with plastic. So here we are, guys. Truck's pulling in. We poured this at a 3,500 pound mix. I think it was a 4,000 pound mix with a little bit of air in it, air entrainment. And I asked for a 5 slump, and it came out to be about a 6 slump. It was kind of loose, a little looser than I wanted because it was really humid out that day, and I didn't really want to be there all day finishing this thing, so it wasn't really exactly what I wanted. But sometimes you got to be careful, tell the driver how much water to put in it, because especially when it's only a couple yards, I think it was 2.5 yards doesn't take much water to change the mix. So we just poured it right out quick. He could reach everything with a couple shoots on there. And that's me just magging off the edge. And my son, Big Biscuit, Jason Big Biscuit, and Trevor are there puddling. And we just poured this, just the three of us poured this out real quick. And we magged off all the edges. And then I'm just going to screed it off by hand. With a, I got a little 8 foot right there, my 8 foot screed. Here I am checking the edges, guys, make sure they're flat. Because I magged off to the line. We have a chalk line snap down there. It's about a 2 inch pitch to this little garage. And I'm just going to pull it off by hand. And Trevor and Jason are puddling behind me. The guys behind me, I call them puddlers. They're just rakers, whatever you want to call it. They're just raking the concrete down as I pull it. And you can tell this is closing up really easy. Usually a wet concrete like this will close real easy. As you can see, there's no honeycombing. If this was a thicker, you know, concrete that was thicker, it wouldn't close up as easy. You'd have to bow float it to get it to close up, which we're going to bow float it anyway. But when it closes up that easy, when you're screeding it, that's a kind of a wet, a little bit wetter than, you know, I asked for, like I said. I mean, it's still strong enough, plenty strong enough. So here I'm checking the edges, just pulling off that edge. And then I'm just going to straight edge my way right out. Jason jumped out of there. Trevor's going to jump out now. And then I'm just kicking my footprints in. And in a second, I'm going to jump out of there and just finish it off. It was real easy, guys. Tiny little pour. I was just glad to get it done this day and take it off my to-do list. We're trying to wrap things up here. I don't like to work past like November 1st. I try to wrap everything up. So right now it's in the middle. It's in the beginning of October right now, guys, for us when I'm doing this video. So we got a few more jobs to do, but we're trying to wrap things up. I don't like to pour concrete and when it's too cold. We're throwing a couple rebars in here just to strengthen up that edge across that doorway. We just pushed them in there and magged them off. Pushed them down in. Me and Trevor are magging it off. And that's how we poured this little one, guys.
Mm-hmm. Seems like it picked up a little bit.
Yeah, it
did. It's
a big one, Ed.
Oh, yeah. We got a big pour on the hands today.
Man.
Took like 16 minutes.
Yeah, I was just about to break a sweat, and then...
You were done.
I didn't end up breaking one.
Look at the handwork.
Yeah,
he's done this a time or two in his day.
I've seen it on YouTube, dude.
Watched it on YouTube?
I did.
Just started pouring today?
Yeah.
First job?
Yeah. Seen it on YouTube. Supposed to be a 5 slump, and I think it's a little thick, thinner than a 5 slump. It's about a 6.5 slump.
Yeah, she looks a little soggy.
Creamy. She's a little creamy for a 5 slump. I guess she must have understood me. You know what I'm saying?
Must have been the rain.
The rain got into the truck.
You never know. So what he's doing right now is he's closing up all these edges. So when they gotta go on it later, they got less work to do. Less cleaning up of the edges. Correct?
I don't think we're gonna need that pile, but if we did, we're gonna wanna put something over it. I don't think we do.
Is it still leaking through?
A little bit. We put plastic over it. Yeah, it's still leaking a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Got a little leakage from our tarp coverage. Put an extra layer of plastic over it. So nice when you're on jobs and you can hit the whole edges without even have to go on it.
Quite a few grippies.
What?
Quite a few grippies.
Yeah.
Quite a few drips.
Yeah.
Let's hope it stops dripping once that water runs out of the tarp.
Yeah, it's over on the side of the house.
Look at that beautiful edge.
Gorgeous.
Almost like you've done it once or twice before.
Yeah.
Have you been watching Bondo Built?
Yeah, check out Bondo Built. Learn how to edge.
I think we're going to want to cover this, honestly. Mm-hmm. Just set some plastic over the whole thing. Right on grade here. Because look at, there's one, two. Look at all the holes.
Yeah.
That's all where it's dripping. So, just set it right on there. I'm going to grab that roll.
That's up there.
Getting sunny like it might stop.
Okay guys, so we threw a piece of plastic on this thing and we went over to another job and ended up cutting a floor that we poured the day before this one here. So this is us just coming back after probably a couple hours. Like I said, it was a little wet when we poured it, wetter than I wanted. So Trevor's out there on a foam knee board. Magging everything off. Me and Biscuit are working the edges, just reaching in there. And we cut the doorway out, guys, tapered the doorway. I didn't video that, but we actually trimmed that. We trimmed these doorways out on garages so that they taper, so that the water will run out. When it hits the garage door, it'll run out. I got a video on doing that. If you look into it, I could show you how to do that. But here we are, just finishing up. Now getting the first hit. We're not going to use a machine for this little thing. I think I said that earlier. We're just going to hand bomb this thing. And that's pretty much the first main hit right there. You know, after we pour it out, this is our first hit. And then, you know, we'll wait another, probably at least an hour or so, hour and a half. It was pretty humid that day, obviously raining out and stuff. And we did have a few leaks in our tarp. But we just kept setting that piece of plastic back on there. Eventually the tarp stopped leaking. wasn't really raining super hard that day. So here I'm just magging off that face on the by the doorway, guys. And then we're going to wait again. I'll start the video up here again when we hit it on the next pass. So this is a couple hours later, guys. I came back. Just going to throw some knee boards on here. And now I've got my finish trowel in my hand. That's a steel trowel. The first one we were using was a mag float, which brings up the cream and knocks the aggregate down. But as it hardens, now I'm going over to my steel trowel. It's a lot thinner. And as the surface hardens, this is what you want to use. So I'm just going to hit along the edges real quick, and then I'm going to kneeboard my way right out this thing. And hand bomb the whole thing. It's not worth putting a power trowel on this thing, guys. It wouldn't even be worth putting it on here for the time it would take to hand trowel it. So that's what I'm doing here. Guys, do me a favor. If you like this video and you're getting some value out of it, go ahead and hit that like button for me. That's going to help me out on YouTube. They'll suggest my videos more to people. It's called algorithm, the way they present your videos to the viewers. You know, the more interaction you get from your audience, the more they suggest the videos and the better they do, guys. So, and if you haven't yet, guys, subscribe to my channel. You know, check it out. We got a lot of videos on there to try to help you guys do concrete. I've been doing concrete for 35 years. This is a real small pour today, guys, but get on the channel. I got over 100 videos on there. Most of them are concrete work, but we live in upstate New York, so during the winter we do take a break from concrete, and I usually fix up. I'll buy a house and fix it up, and usually rent them out, and that's what we do in the winter time. So we like to build stuff. We like to fix things up. So we give you some good tips there on some insulation stuff that we do in the winter, and just overall some good DIY stuff on there for people that like this kind of stuff. So again, check it out, guys. Hit the like, subscribe to my channel, share it on social media, and thanks again for watching my stuff. And my subscribers that have already subscribed, I really appreciate the support. Keep them comments coming. I like that. Any questions you got, definitely hit me up with that, and I'll make sure I get right back to you on any questions you got. Okay, guys, all set with this one. Build a little tent here, and we poured this little floor. Come on, pretty good. I just hand troweled it, as you see in the video. Come on, pretty good. Well, here she is, guys. Got her all hand troweled. Got a little cap there to catch the rainwater. It's dripping. I got one dripping here. There's a few holes in this tarp, so we put a little cap there to catch it. It's got a little taper to this floor, 2 inches. Pretty easy little floor to pour. Kind of sucked we had to build this tarp, but it's hard to get concrete right now. Concrete's 2 weeks out, so I didn't want to wait. So it only took us like an hour to build this little tarp or tent here out of tarps. And that's how we did it today, guys. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.